All right, so first, overtake place at Silverstone is this corner after the long straight, obviously. Now, you know, people think long straight, slipstream, I will overtake here. It's not easy because this corner is quite fast, it's medium speed. So it's not that you can do a lot, you know, but actually, maybe you cannot overtake here, but you can prepare the overtake maneuver for the next turn. So what you can do many things. Possibly the adversary will stay on the inside right here, okay? So what you can do is that you can possibly try to make him brake later. So you brake later, and he will see you, and he will try to, you know, brake later or release the brakes a little bit to get on the side of you, all right? And that means that he will be at the inside line over here, and obviously he will either have to go very slow into the apex, okay? And at this point, you can do a couple of things. So either he will go fast enough here and he will end up very wide at the exit. And so you can make a different turn, a little bit slower at the entry, cross the line and get faster at the exit, okay? Or you can let him go slow, because you know that if he stays here and he makes the turn and stays inside, okay, so if he's, let me go at the top, give me a second. Oops, come on. So what we want to do here, oops, wrong. Okay. So what we want to do here is, if he manages to stay on the inside and go slow and remain on the apex like that, okay, you can stay a little bit on the outside and do a late apex. So he will start going wide like this, and you can start here. Now, if you have let some space between him and you, he might think that, okay, you know, I'm getting space, no big deal, oops. So no big deal, and he will go outside like this. But you can be faster at the exit with a better line, and you can get his slipstream at the exit of this turn. That means that you can be much closer and getting the slipstream for the next braking zone around here. So these are two ways that you can prepare the overtaking maneuver over here, right? So this is one. So again, either, so you stay somewhere around here, you try to close to remain close to him, but obviously do not overdo it. And you either let him go and you cross the line, or you let him go, okay, and get a better exit so that at the exit of the corner, you are faster than him. If you've managed to be faster than him, you can again get the slipstream. Now, usually what is going to happen is that if he sees that you are faster than him, okay, he will try to stay on the inside of the road here, okay? And so he will let you the outside. Now, obviously, you're going to say, well, again, I won't be able to overtake. It's not, the overtaking maneuver does not end here. It doesn't end here. Again, this is preparation, because here's what it can happen. So you arrive like that, okay? He goes, obviously, into the turn with a much more narrow line like this, and of course he's gonna end up very wide at the next turn. This is your opportunity. So you want to go inside in a better line than him, Let him even gain some space. So if he goes wide and he's in front of you like this, okay, doesn't matter. Don't try to stay close to him when you follow him into this turn. Let him go wide, okay? And what you want to do is exit the turn here so that when your opponent will be very narrow, having to, you know, make this turn very, very narrow like this. Oops, completely messed up everything, sorry. So he will be forced to do a very narrow turn like this. You will be able to do a much better wide line like that. And this means that you are going to exit the turn much, much better, okay? Much higher exit speed. Now, a couple of things might happen. He either is going to end up very wide here, and you will be able to accelerate through here and pass him, or he will be able to do this, but he will be so slow that you again be able to come alongside him, and this time you're going to be you're going to be at the inside place of the next turn. So what we have done until now, this is very important to understand. Our whole, let me show you, because it is really important how you start. The whole strategy of the overtake, okay, started from this turn, after the long straight, okay. So you go outside, you know that usually the guys will try to defend. You go outside here, okay. You try to take advantage of the exit. You go outside here again. Again, here you're outside. He will try to defend, he will stay on the inside, okay. And you go outside again here, and finally, at the last turn, you have the opportunity to go inside. So see how we starting, you know, doing the usual attack maneuver here, and usually your opponent defends on the inside, and you might think, okay, I cannot do anything. You go outside, but this helps you to go outside again here, inside here, last turn. Now, if your opponent thinks that you know more than him and you are, you know, more clever than him, so he stays outside here, instantly you have the opportunity to overtake him here. If he stays outside here again, you have the opportunity to overtake him inside. So, as you can see, it's a sequence of turns that even if your opponent defends, you still have an opportunity at the last turn. If your opponent doesn't defend, then, you know, you can just try the proper overtaking maneuver and see how it goes. So it's very interesting what you can do into these turns. All right, so let's move on. Now, we are arriving again to the next overtake opportunity. So, very fast into this turn again. As we said, go over here. Possibly you are following the car very closely. Flat out on the next turn again. Great. And at some point, you both arrive somewhere around here. Okay, great. So what to do now? So, the usual again. So if your opponent defends on the inside, so you are so close that your opponent stays into this line, okay, and doesn't give you space on the inside, you can go outside. Okay. Now, what is going to happen? Many things can happen into these turns. Let me show you from above. There's really many, many things that can happen here. Okay? So how can I stop again? I have to stop it like this. Sorry for the HUD. So if your opponent stays on the inside, oops, like that, okay, now this is the line that your opponent is going to be forced to do. In that case, you could try and do this, okay? That's obviously logical. Now, after that, again, your opponent will be able to defend. So this is not a great tactic, but sometimes, you know, sometimes it works. It depends how experienced your opponent is. If your opponent is able to make the turn, then, you know, you can try a couple of times. If you see that always makes the turn, then no big deal here. If your opponent is not very experienced and tries to stay on the inside, but you see that he's going wide every time here, he loses a lot of time if he's going wide. So in that case, you can try to break later than him, cross the line, and overtake him like that. Good. Another thing that can happen here, you can just follow the car in front of you. So you're not exactly in the condition to do the overtaking maneuver. So you just follow the car in front of you. You're both doing the line like this. Okay. And because the car in front of you is, you know, it thinks that, okay, I have the line, I'm in front, no big deal. He might make the mistake and go wide here to make a better turn. Now, the one and only David Perel did an amazing overtake maneuver in real life in exactly this turn at the Silverstone race, and he had also practiced that turn into the simulator. Sometimes it works, sometimes not. So what you can do, as I said, is that you follow the car in front of you, you don't do any overtake maneuvers here, you keep on following, okay, you keep on following, you keep on following. Right at the end, instead of going wide, you go really on the inside like this. You break really, really late in a straight line. Now, what you're trying to do here? What you're trying to do is you try to break very late. If your opponent is here and he's a good opponent, he sees you, you do the dive bomb. And even if you go a little bit wide, your opponent cannot do anything else that stay wide, because otherwise he will go against you, right? It's a maneuver that works, but it is a risky maneuver. Why? Because I saw you before that when you are here, you can't even see where the apex is. Go figure if there is another car. So it's very risky. Your opponent might just, you know, turn into the turn, and he doesn't even know that you are there, and you're gonna crash. So it's a risky maneuver. But, you know, dive bombing in such a slow speed corners works sometimes. I'm not telling you to do it. If you do it, you have to also know that it's your risk. And if an accident happens, it's your responsibility, right? So you take the responsibility, you say, okay, I'm doing the dive. Let's see what's going to happen. But, you know, sometimes it works. In reality, it worked for David Perel. In an official race online, I saw David Perel trying that. It didn't work. They had an accident. It wasn't easy. It wasn't nice. So, yeah. So this is it mainly. Those are the two most important overtaking maneuvers that you can do into this track. There are other places that you can try to overtake, but usually these are the sequence of turns where the overtaking happens. All right?